Tengo un mensaje del Dios Todopoderoso en esta noche.
What you do with Jesus Christ will determine where you spend eternity.
Lo que hagan con Jesucristo va a determinar dónde se pasan la eternidad.
The word of God says in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
La palabra de Dios dice que Dios envió a su Hijo Jesucristo para que todo aquel que en él cree no se pierda, mas tenga vida eterna.
For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved.
Porque Dios no ha enviado a su Hijo al mundo para condenar al mundo, sino que para que el mundo a través de él sea salvo.
What you do with Jesus Christ will determine where you spend eternity.
Lo que hagan con Jesucristo va a determinar dónde pasan la eternidad.
The word of God says there was a man named Abraham, and God had a plan because there was two cities called Sodom and Gomorrah. And God spoke to Abraham, and the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do, since Abraham will surely become a great and mighty nation, and in him all the nations of the earth will be blessed. For I have chosen him so that he might command his children and his household after him to keep the way of the Lord by doing righteousness and justice, so that the Lord may bring upon Abraham what he has spoken about him.
God spoke to a man named Abraham and told him there's two cities, Sodom and Gomorrah, and he was going to burn them down because there was so much wickedness. The world is full of violence these days. COVID-19 is still going on, and there are people that are still not turning from their wicked ways. But God is commanding everyone everywhere to repent and to believe in the gospel.
The word of God says that Jesus himself said that before he comes back, it would be like the days of Noah.
How were the days of Noah?
The days of Noah, people were just living in sin and unrighteousness. People were getting drunk all the time. There was so much homosexuality going on. There was so much fornication and adultery going on. There was just so much sin in the world that God looked down and he said, I will destroy the earth. And he brought a flood upon the earth. And the only people that were saved were Noah and his family. And in the time of Lot, God spoke to Abraham and he told them that he was going to burn those two cities down because there was so much violence going on, so much sexual immorality going on. But Abraham said, Lord, if I find 50 people, will you destroy the righteous with the wicked at the same time? And God said, if you find 50 people, I will not destroy the cities for the sake of 50 people. So Abraham went and tried to find 50 righteous people.
Abraham fue y habló con Dios y le dijo, Señor, si encuentro a 50 personas justas, ¿destruirás al justo igualmente con el impío?
Y Dios le dijo, Abraham, si encuentras 50 personas, no voy a destruir las ciudades.
But Abraham could not find 50 righteous people. And Abraham went to God and said, if I can find 45 righteous people, will you still destroy the righteous with the wicked?
Y Abraham no pudo encontrar 45 personas justas.
Y Abraham le dijo a Dios, Señor, si encuentro 40 personas justas, ¿todavía vas a destruir las ciudades?
Y Dios le dijo, ve, encuentra 40 personas justas.
y no pudo encontrar 40. So Abraham went back and he said, Lord, if I can find 30. And he went back and he said, Lord, if I can find 20 righteous people. And he went back and he said, Lord, if I can find 10 righteous people. But Abraham could not find 10 righteous people, because there's a lot of people that say that they believe in God, but with their life, they demonstrate that they don't truly believe in God, because they don't obey God. They don't follow God. They just say it with their lips. Jesus said, there's a people that honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far away from me. Abraham no pudo encontrar ni a 10 personas justas. Así que Dios tuvo que destruir las ciudades de Sodoma y Gomorra. Porque hay muchas personas que dicen que creen en Dios, pero es solamente con su mente, porque sus corazones están lejos de Dios. There's many people that believe in God, but only with their mind, because their hearts are far away from God. But God is calling people to repent and to believe in Him and to trust in Him and to follow Him. Because many people say they have their own religion. Many people say, I have my own religion. I don't need anything. But God says, come to me. Because Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one goes to the Father except through me. Many people are trying to get to God by their good works. Many people are trying to get to God by the religious acts that they do. But look at this world, how it is, and people still say they believe in God. If people truly believed in God, people would repent and they would love one another and they would treat each other with respect and with love. Muchas personas dicen que creen en Dios y que aman a Dios. Pero miren cómo está el mundo ahorita. El mundo está caído. Hay mucho racismo y mucho odio. There's so much racism and hate. There is so much violence going on in the world. But Jesus Christ said, if you love me, you would follow my commandments. And what you do with Jesus Christ will determine where you spend eternity.
Una vez más, lo que hagan con Jesucristo va a determinar dónde se pasan la eternidad.
God is calling and demanding that every person repent and turn over their life to God. Because there are people that are living their life in sin. There are people that are not married and they're committing fornication. There are people that are married and are committing adultery. And the Bible says that no adulterous person will inherit the kingdom of God. That no fornicator will inherit the kingdom of God. But God is a God that so loved the world that he gave his only son. Pero Dios es un Dios que amó tanto al mundo que dio a su único hijo. And that is why God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. So many people claim to be religious, but where has your religion gotten you? Because it's not about being religious. It's about following God and living a holy life. It's about following God and obeying His word. There's people that say they follow God, that they're servants of God, and God calls His people to go out and preach the eternal gospel. He sent His disciples to go out and preach the gospel, and He told them, go out and preach the gospel to every creature. Whosoever believes and is baptized shall be saved. Hay muchas personas que se dicen ser siervos de Dios, pues Dios nos manda a ir a predicar el evangelio, que todo aquel que crea y sea bautizado será salvo. You know, there are many people that claim to be atheists even. They claim not to believe in God. But one day the Bible says it is appointed unto everyone to die once. And after this is the judgment. We will all face God one day. Some people tell me, where is God? Where is God? God is in heaven. And God is omniscient. He is everywhere. God cannot be limited. God is almighty and He knows all things. God knows your heart. And God knows that people say that they believe in God, But he knows that they are not following the Lord. But I say to you today, before the presence of the Lord, that you must choose today whom you will serve. Whether you will serve God or whether you will serve yourself. But God is the only one that offers salvation. It is only through Jesus Christ that people may be saved, because there is no other name given unto men under heaven in which we shall be saved. Because many people think they're going to heaven by their good works or because they think they're a good person. But it is only through God. It is only through Jesus Christ. Because he is the only one that died and resurrected from the dead. There are many people that say they have a God. But where is he? God is alive. God is alive. And he will judge the living and the dead. That is the reason why we preach. The Apostle Paul, he said, I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone who believes. El Apostle Pablo dijo, yo no me avergüenzo del evangelio, porque es el poder de Dios para salvación a todos los que creen en su nombre. Jesucristo salva. Jesus Christ is the only hope for this world. It is Jesus Christ. You know, we're going through a pandemic and we are praying that this will end. Estamos pasando por esta pandemia y estamos orando a Dios que esto termine. We are praying that this pandemic ends. But what happens when it ends? What are we going to do? Because God calls us to come to him, to believe in him, to trust in him, because he can do all things. And he has called us to repentance and to holiness. Praise the Lord. Teach your children the word of God, so when they are older, they will not depart. Enséñenles a sus hijos la palabra de Dios, para cuando crezcan, que no se aparten de la palabra de Dios. It is up to us to teach our children the word of God so that then when they are old, they will not depart from the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Because it is not about religious keeping. It is about following God. Because it is through him that salvation comes. You know, maybe you're going through a difficult time in your life right now. God can save you. God can give you a new life. And Jesus Christ said you must be born again. Jesucristo te puede dar una vida nueva. Y él dijo, tienes que nacer de nuevo. Jesus Christ said, unless you are born again, you cannot enter the kingdom of God. Jesucristo dijo, a menos que nazcas de nuevo, no puedes entrar en el reino de los cielos. It is through Jesus Christ that we go to heaven. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one goes to the Father except through me. Many people are trying to go to heaven by so many other ways. But it is only through Jesus Christ. Those of you that have a Bible, read it, follow it, put it to practice. Talk to your family about the Word of God. Don't ever be ashamed of it. We can die tonight, and then what's going to happen? Because we do have an appointment with death, and we're not going to miss it. But after that is the judgment. How will we escape? How will we escape if we neglect such a great salvation? ¿Cómo escaparemos si rechazamos tan grande salvación? The Word of God says that salvation is found through Jesus Christ. It is through Jesus Christ that we get our joy and our peace. It is through Jesus Christ that we get our food. And everything that we have, our family, comes from God. The food comes from God. The peace and the joy comes from God.
Todo lo que tenemos proviene de Dios. La salvación viene de Dios. La paz viene de Dios. El gozo viene de Dios. Nuestros familiares vienen de Dios. Nuestros amigos, todo lo que tenemos proviene de Dios. Everything that we have comes from Almighty God. Our life is in His hands and He is in control. And again, we are praying that this nightmare of this pandemic will end, so we can be with our family again, so we can be with our friends again and rejoice. We are praying that this pandemic will end soon, because most people see this as a nightmare, and it is. But in the name of Jesus, it will end, so that we can praise Him freely. Praise the Lord. God is good all the time. And even now, look at this, even through this pandemic, God gives us this great opportunity to be able to come to these restaurants and eat and rejoice, to be able to see people, because it feels good to see people walking around and sitting down and enjoying their food and their desserts. Porque se siente bien mirar a las personas caminando y disfrutando, disfrutando de la comida, disfrutando de su familia, disfrutando de sus familias. It feels good. It feels good to rejoice and be able to be out here. But God calls us to a relationship with Himself. God says, let us reason with one another. If your sins are as red as scarlet, they will be as white as snow. But Jesus says, you must repent and believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ. Let me ask you a question. How is your life with God? How is your relationship with God? Déjenme les hago una pregunta. ¿Cómo está su vida con Dios? How is your relationship with God? Because many people say they believe in Him, but many people are just living their life, just doing whatever they please. But God calls us to a relationship with Himself, so that we can be saved, so that we can be free indeed, to be able to rejoice in Him. What are you going to do with the message of the gospel that you hear? ¿Qué van a hacer con el mensaje del evangelio que escuchan? Because the Bible says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. God bless you, young people. God is good all the time. Praise the Lord. It is good that we are out here. It is good that God gives us this opportunity to rejoice. God is awesome. God is mighty to be praised. God is good all the time. Even throughout all this pandemic, God is still good. And we rejoice. Aún a través de esta pandemia, Dios es bueno. Y todavía nos podemos gozar. I pray to God that you hear His voice and do not harden your hearts, but to open up your heart. To open up your heart to God and to believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ. We will hear the word of God from the time we're born to the time we die until the day we face Him. Vamos a escuchar la palabra de Dios desde que nacemos hasta que nos muremos, hasta que estemos de pie delante de Él. Because there will be no excuse when we stand before God. There will be no excuse when we stand before God. We will all give an account to God for every word that we speak and for every action that we do in this body. But there is forgiveness in Christ if we ask Him to forgive us. There's so many people that are living a life of depression right now, but there is hope in Jesus Christ. There is hope in God. We're praying for this pandemic to end, but it still feels good that even now we're able to be out here. We're able to see each other. God bless you. We're able to see people. And it feels good that some restaurants are open again. Oh, because we're able to rejoice. God is good. La palabra de Dios dice que no hay otro nombre dado bajo de los cielos en cual el hombre pueda ser salvo. La palabra de Dios es como una espada de dos filos que penetra el corazón. The word of God is like a double-edged sword. It penetrates the heart. And the Holy Spirit is the one that brings conviction that we may repent and follow Him so that we may be saved. Para que se salven. There is love in Jesus Christ. There's a lot of people that have religion, but they hate people. There's people that are hating other people because they're not from their own religion. But we gotta preach Jesus Christ, and Jesus Christ is love. Jesus Christ loves you. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, His only begotten Son, so that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo, que ha dado su Hijo unigénito, para que todo aquel que en él cree no se pierda, mas tenga vida eterna. I gave my life to God, and some people hate me. You know, some people would rather see people on drugs, or drunk, or beating people up, instead of seeing people preaching the gospel, preaching Jesus Christ. If I was to go to another country, they would probably stone me for preaching about God. Si fuera otro país a predicar el evangelio, and some of us are going into other countries preaching the word of God, because the word of God is for everyone. God is for everyone, so everyone will be saved. I praise the Lord because we're able to go into other places. We're able to go into other places and talk about God, and talk about the forgiveness and the mercy of God, and His mercies are new every day. If you're alive today, it's because God has mercy. La misericordia de Dios es nueva cada día. Si estamos vivos hoy, es por la misericordia de Dios. If we are alive today, it's because the mercy of God, and His mercies are new every morning, that we may get to know Him. Because God is love. Whoever knows God lives in love. Todo aquel que conoce a Dios conoce el amor, porque Dios es amor. Pero Dios demanda que todos se arrepientan y lo sigan y lo sirvan. But God demands for everyone to repent and to follow Him. Follow Jesus Christ. Follow Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord. God is good. I pray to God that you hear this message and you open up your heart. Because who knows? Who knows when will be the next time that you will hear the word of God? Le pido a Dios que escuchen esta palabra y abran su corazón. Porque quién sabe cuándo va a ser la otra vez que escuchen la palabra de Dios. Who knows when will be the next time that God will allow you to hear His word? Because God says that there's going to be a day where He's going to send a famine, not a food or hunger, but not a hunger for food, but a hunger for His word. La palabra de Dios dice que Dios va a mandar un hambre de la palabra de Dios. There's going to be a day when people are going to want to hear this book, the Bible, the Holy Bible of God, but no one's going to be preaching it anymore. God's going to come back and take His people. But you can become His people if you repent and follow Him. Va a haber un día donde Dios va a venir por su pueblo. Y ustedes pueden ser su pueblo si se arrepienten y lo siguen. You can become a child of God. You can become a follower of God. You can be saved. There has been many people that have preached the word of God, and God is the one that sends them. I'm not talking about the prosperity preachers, because you need to be careful with them. Be careful. We have to preach the truth of the word of God. We have to preach the sound doctrine of God. Not everyone who says to God, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but only those that do the will. Jesus said of my Father who is in heaven. Many people say, I believe in God, I believe in God, but they don't follow him. They don't repent of their sins.
Jesucristo dijo, no todo aquel que me dice Señor, Señor, entrará en el reino de los cielos, sino todo aquel que haga la voluntad de mi Padre que está en los cielos.
For there will be a day when people will say to God, Lord, in your name I cast out demons. In your name I preached. In your name I did all these things. But Jesus is going to tell them, depart from me, you doers of iniquity. I never knew you. I pray that you repent and believe, and that your name gets written in the book of life. Because Jesus said, only those that come to him will be saved. Jesús dijo, no todo aquel que me diga Señor, Señor, va a entrar en el reino de los cielos, sino todo aquel que haga la voluntad de mi Padre que está en los cielos. Porque dice Cristo, en aquel día muchos me van a decir, Señor, en tu nombre eché fuera demonios, en tu nombre prediqué, pero va a decir, apártense de mí, malditos, nunca los conocí. Le pido a Dios que se arrepientan y crean en Cristo, que su nombre esté escrito en el libro de la vida. I pray that you receive Jesus Christ, that you repent, that your name may be written in the book of life. Gloria a Dios. Praise the Lord. Thank you for listening to me today. Those that heard the word of God, thank you. Thank you. God is good. May God bless you and your families. Praise the Lord. Thank you. Que Dios bendiga a todos los que me escucharon en esta noche. Que Dios los bendiga a ustedes y a toda su familia. Jesucristo viene pronto. Jesus Christ will be back soon. God bless you.